Go. All right. Hey guys. I'm Trina. This is Bar. We are going to do a warm-up, then we'll do our arm series. We'll do our bar series. I have a chair right here for the bar portion. I recommend a chair or something else for balance. Then we'll do our core series. I have my mat for that, and then we will cool down. Equipment you need, small hand weights. If you don't have hand weights, you could use two water bottles or just use, you know, body weight. I also recommend paper plates to use as a glider. And I have a ball, but that's not at all necessary. But if you have a ball, then you can just grab it and have it available. So let's start with our warm up. First, let's just get ourselves in position. Let's put our feet underneath our hips. Strong legs, start to engage those leg muscles. Take your pelvis. I don't want you to tuck because that's like squinching your booty and that's not, I just want you to get like a one, tighten your core and just take a little curve out of your spine, just enough to make sure that your core is engaged. So we're just tightening the core. Lift your rib cage up off of your waist. So tall, 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 create as much distance here as you can. Roll your shoulders back and feel this great posture before we get started. So you want to feel that lifted rib cage, that engaged core throughout the class. And we are going to get started. Let's start our warm up in second position. So feet are really wide, wider than hip distance. Your toes are at about a 45 degree angle. When we come down into our plie, I want you to make sure that you can see your big toes on the inside of your knees. If your knees are collapsing forward, that's putting too much pressure on your joints. Just close up your feet until you can see your big toes on the inside. So getting into that second position, let's extend our arms and we'll just start with a simple plie. Plie, nice. Just a little gentle motion here to get started. As you come down into that plie, holding on to your core to keep your chest upright. The natural motion of your body is to compensate for dropping those glutes by bending forward at the waist just to maintain that equilibrium. We are fighting against that by engaging our core and keeping our strong chest and shoulders facing right up to the sky. Nice. Four more like this. Three, then we're gonna hold it down. Two, hold it down. I should have said our theme today is one-sided work. We're gonna stay down here. We're gonna lift one heel and then the other. So we're gonna be doing a lot of work on one side and then the other. I like doing one-sided work because we all have a stronger side and a weaker side. And when we work both sides together, often compensate for that weaker side with the stronger side. But if you isolate the work to one side, then that weak side has to work just as hard. Keep lifting these heels. Lift, lift. Re-engage that core. Recommit to head straight up to the ceiling. Four. Three, two, one, both heels up, drop one. Drop one, drop one, drop one. Drop, drop. Nice job, you guys. I'm seeing amazing control here. Everyone is staying down in this plie. It's definitely starting to burn. Keep it up. Don't let go for four, three, two, and one. Rise it up. Nice job. Shake out those legs. We're gonna come into developpe kicks. So first position, heels together, zip up those legs, tall, tall, tall. Again, let's have our arms out in second position for balance. We are going to do side to side developpe kicks. Developpe means we'll develop this kick. So we start here, extend, bring it down. Run your leg up, develop out into that kick, bring it down. Nice, slow and controlled to start. This is challenging our balance side to side. You can feel free to get that chair if you're not ready to balance so early in your workout. Develop A, keeping the turnout in that leg. So thinking about leading with the heel up to the sky. Develop A. Nice. Four, three, two, and one. Speed it up. Out, out. Don't lose your motion here of this develop A motion, and do not lose that control in the core and the upper body. Four, again, three, again, two, again, last set, and here we go. All right, our final warm-up move, now let me start our timer here, is going to be a glissade. So a glissade is a jump from side to side, a jump from one foot to the other, jump. You can step. If you don't want to put the pressure on your joints of jumping, try to catch your balance on each side, starting and ending on a bent knee, as with any jump, side to side, working on your distance. Nice. Jump, jump, and again, this landing on each foot keeps us honest with our balance, with working each side equally. Jump, jump. Four, jump. Three, jump. Two, jump. Last set and jump. Nice job. I hope that your heart is beating now. You've got some oxygen going. We're gonna go into our arm series. So pick up your little weights. We're gonna start with a fly. So for our fly, feet under hips, roll those shoulders back. 45 degree angle here from the hips. So we're not bending at the waist. We're at the hips, straight back. No booty up, no booty in. Straight back, rolling those shoulders back. Fly those arms into the air. Fly, squeezing your shoulder blades behind you. This is work for your shoulders, but it is more work, or it should be more work, for your back. So this work is coming from a really strong contraction in that back, drawing those shoulder blades together. Lift in the fly, lift in the fly. Feel your core strong underneath you, maintaining that great spinal length. Four more like this, three more like this, two more like this. Last one, keep them up, drop one, and then the other. Drop one, and then the other. Again, focus the work in the back. Nice, fly, 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 fly. Big squeeze at the top. Squeeze down, big squeeze and down, big squeeze and down. Squeeze, four, squeeze, three, squeeze, we're not done, two, squeeze, last one, squeeze, squeeze for your pulse, 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 pulse. Keep it going, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, Release. Nice. Your back should be nice and warm. Now we're gonna do a rope climb shoulder press side to side. So keeping our elbows really open, they wanna fall to the front, but we wanna keep them really open. We're gonna do a rope climb press. Just reaching up and up, up and up. So keeping your hips in the same spot. So we're not rocking back and forth on our hips. We're just lifting that rib cage tall, one side to the other, and letting my elbows fall forward. I wanna keep them back. Lift, lift, lift. This is engaging your core as well with this rope climb motion. Lift, lift, lift. You can turn your hands to the center now to get a little bit of a different work. Lift, lift, lift. Keep it up. Lift, lift, lift. Nice job. Up, up, up. Four, three, two, and one. Coming into our side raise. Again, roll those shoulder blades back, arms out to the side. We're gonna alternate dropping. Drop and rise. Drop and rise. Again, this is more in the shoulders than the fly, but you should still feel it in your back. Your back should be nice and warm from those flies. So it should not be hard to engage here. Holding onto that core. Drop and lift. Drop and lift. Really sticking that lift. That arm doesn't move once you stick it in the air. Lift down and up, down and up, down and up. Four and up, three and up, two and up. We're not done. One and hold, pulse one, hand only, pulse one arm. Pulse, 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 pulse. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hold that arm, other arm, pulse. Pulse, pulse, pulse. Keep it up, that pulse, that first arm is really talking to you. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Together, just for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release. Nice. Coming back into that posture, that ski posture that we did for our flies, we are going to do our triceps. So we're going to take those palms, try to keep them up above the booty, palms up to the sky, pulse, pulse, pulse. Let's work on these triceps. Pulse, pulse, pulse. Nice, shoulders rolled back. Pulse, pulse. Head neutral, your gaze should be ahead of you, kind of maybe looking at the where the floor meets the wall ahead of you, not all the way down at the floor. If you drop your head, then you'll have some major head rush problems later. Pulse, 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 pulse. Keep it up. 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring them in, 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 in. Triceps in, in, in. Keep it up. Shoulders back. Hands above the booty if you can. In, in, in. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release. Final move here, we're gonna do some bicep work. So again, feet right under your hips, arms out. We are gonna have palms up to the sky. We're gonna do rib cage isolation. So actually I'm gonna spread my feet just a little to keep my hips rock solid. We're going to reach to one side, bicep curl. Reach to the other side, bicep curl. Reach, reach, reach. Nice, reach. Keeping those hips in one place, just doing that rib cage isolation. Nice. Reach arms up parallel with the shoulders. Reach. Keep it going. Biceps here. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, weights down. We're gonna come into our bar series. I'm gonna get my chair here to be in the bar. We're going to start with a rond de jambe. You can have a glider, a paper plate if you want, or you could just have your foot on the floor. So rond de jambe, it means circle of the leg. So we're just gonna have our toe on here. Very simple to start. We're just gonna circle, bring it through. Circle, bring it through. Circle, bring it through. Okay, now that we have this motion, we're going to do rond de jambe, rond de jambe, and then we're gonna come into a grand. Bend that standing knee really deep. Draw it through. Petite, petite, and grand. Nice. Petite, petite, and grand. Good. So you should feel when you're coming into that plie, really engage the core to stay upright. Demi, demi, grand, come through. Demi, demi, grand, bring it through. One more like this. Demi, grand, bring it through. Stay down here in this plie. Take these circles in your plie. Staying down here really deep. 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, play to the side. Second set, all air. So we're going to be up in the air. Demi, come through. Demi, come through. Grand, bring it back up. Demi, demi, coming into that plie for the grand. Demi, demi, plie. So very important, we're keeping our hips in the same place. We're not opening them, we're not moving them. Everything from the hips up is completely stationary. We're just moving that leg in the hip socket. Grand, come through. I think that was 3 demis, but hopefully we're okay with that. Demi, grand, come through. Demi, demi, grand, stay here for 8, 7, 6. Tall, tall, not leaning forward. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Other side. So starting on the floor, you can have your glider if you would like. Do that. Demi, demi, and grand, come through. Do this one. Demi, demi, grand, bring it through. Demi, tall, tall, engaged core. Grand, bring it through. Demi, demi, grand. Nice. So feeling this nice circular motion, starting to get some equal work on the other leg. One more like this, then we'll hold it down. Demi, Grand Sam, it's Grand Bring It Through. Staying in this plie. Constant work in that standing leg. Nice, you guys. Completely stationary from the hips up. 4, 3, 2, 1. Rise it up, glider to the side. Second set, en l'air. Demi, demi, grand, really big. Demi, demi, grand, nice. I'm loving these huge circles that I'm seeing. Demi, grand, through. Demi, really good control in that core, you guys. I love what I'm seeing. Demi, demi, plie, grand, go. Two more like this. Demi, grand, bring it through. Demi, demi, staying down in this grand for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Beautiful. Shake it out. We are going to come out of our turnout for our next move. We're going to do single leg squats with tendus. So it's a little similar, but our feet will be in parallel. So before we were really focusing on the outer and the inner thighs, we're going to go more of the glutes here. So our standing leg, your foot in first, is straight. So we're going to start with the tendu. Just point that toe, bring it in, squat. To the side, squat. To the back, squat. Side, squat. Front, squat. So a squat, your body will naturally lean forward a little. We're not in our turnout to give that space for our hips to just go straight down, but still concentrate on that core, on keeping the upper body lifted and tall. We're really sitting back into that standing leg, sitting back into it. Knee is staying behind those toes, preferably right above the ankle. So squatting motion, definitely not a plie here. And you should really be feeling that nice engagement in the glute. 4, 3, 2, back in, pulse, pulse, pulse. Keep this other toe off the floor, or you can set it on the floor for balance. Pulse, 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 strong core. Pulse, pulse, pulse. Really just getting a little bit into that glute here. Pulse, pulse, pulse. Pulse, 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 tall, tall, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice. Whew. Definitely felt that going on in my glute. So let's get the other one. So tendu front. So setting up those feet, feet facing toward the front, tendu front, squat. Side, squat, back, squat. And it doesn't feel like anything for the first several rounds. And then suddenly it starts to kick in. Back, squat, side, squat, back, squat, side, squat. Nice, just keep working it. It's gonna get there. Thinking about your tall core, your strong core and your tall spine with your head up to the ceiling. In front, squat, side, squat, back, squat, side, squat. One more set, front, squat, side, squat, back, squat, side. Here we go with our pulse, pulse, pulse. Again, straight up and down with that spine. Let me see if you can, keeping that knee behind the toes, glutes behind you. Pulse, pulse, pulse. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, shake that out. We're gonna do a little bit of standing core. So feet in first position. We're gonna come up into releve, so walk your heels together so that they're touching. Releve is always optional. You can always stay flat feet, holding onto our bar or chair for balance. And we're just gonna reach up and over and open. Up and over and open. So feeling those thighs zip together, keeping the heels, calves, thighs together, focusing on rib cage, up and over, tall, tall. Don't let those heels drop if you're up in releve. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and pulse over the side. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Other side. Releve, up and over and open, up and over and open. So this is a little sneaky. It's sort of the other side, but it's kind of also the exact same thing. So you're not really getting a break of any kind, but it feels a little different, right? With your other hand getting the balance. Squeezing those thighs together, squeezing those heels together. Nice. Up and over, up and over. 4, 3, 2, and pulse, 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 pulse. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice job coming down. Shake out those calves, especially. You might want to just get a little stretch in your calves. Before we move on to our next move, I'm going to use the ball. Ball totally, totally optional. I'm going to have the ball in the crook of the knee. And I'm just having it there for form. And leg straight behind you. We're going to circle that knee just a little bit. Circle out. Circle, circle, circle. Trying to keep the knee raised up in the air. Try not to let that hip open to the side. So trying to have both hip bones pointed down. Circle, 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 circle. 4, 3, 2, switch directions. Circle, 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 circle. That little inner circle. Engage the inner thigh. Circle, 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 circle. 4, 3, 2, 1. Tuck in, bring it out. Tuck in, bring it out. Tuck and out. Tuck and out. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, two, and one, and release. Other side, little circles, leg extended, circle out first, out, circle, circle. Again, both hips down, both shoulders down, circle, 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 trying to keep that heel, the sole of the foot up to the ceiling. Circle, 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 circle. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, other direction. Circle in, 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 in. And this is a little movement. Bar is really about leveraging little movements to build little muscles. So right here, we're working on these stabilizers on the outside of the glutes. This is also, it should be working your back a little bit as you use those muscles to keep your knee lifted in the air. 8, 7, 6, 5, your hamstrings, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now tuck, extend, tuck, extend, tuck, extend, tuck, extend for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice. Okay, our last move at the bar. Coming back to that glider or paper plate, we're going to do a lateral lunge. So I'm gonna move my bar to the side, but you can definitely keep yours for balance. We're going to bend the moving leg. So lateral lunge, deep bend, draw it in. When you draw it in, I want you to engage that inner thigh all the way along the floor. So it's not a passive movement. That drawing in is actually the biggest part of the movement here, working on those inner thighs. Nice, you guys. I love this one because especially when we don't have access to the gym, it can be a little hard to get your inner thighs. You can set up a resistance band, you know, to under a table leg or whatever and use that, but this is a nice, simple, low or no equipment move to work those inner thighs. 4, 3, 2, 1, bring it in, now bring it out, stay here, pulse, 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 pulse. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. One last drag, 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 drag as slow as you can. And release. Coming to the other side. Moving leg is bending. Slowly draw it in. Moving leg is bending. Slowly draw it in. Nice. So again, we're not letting go of our upper body. We're keeping hold of that core. Your core is helping to draw you in. You don't want to be jerking your body. You just want the work to stay in these legs, particularly these inner thighs. So keeping your core engaged helps you fight against the impulse to use momentum here. Draw it in and out. Draw it in and out. Two more, in and out. Last one and out, stay here. Pulse, 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 pulse. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slowly drag it in as slow as you can. Slow, 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 slow. And release. All right, we're done with our bar series. We're gonna get our mats and come down to the floor for our core series. Drink. We are going to start with a plank variation. So passe, as you may recall, make sure this is in the frame for the most part. Okay, passe is just where you bring your toe to your knee. We are going to do that in a plank. You can always be on your knees or on your toes, whatever's comfortable for you. If you're on your knees, just alternate bringing your toe. If you're on your toes, we're gonna come up into passe, passe. So while we're in this plank and we're in this motion, the goal is to keep those hips in one place. Your body wants to roll side to side as you change your balance from one side to the other. We're resisting that step. Passe, 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 passe. Keep it going. Strong through the shoulders. Don't drop your head. Your gaze should be at the front edge of your mat. If you drop your head, you're gonna have a real bad time when your head lifts back up. Four, other side. Three, other side. Two, other side of the last set, and we're gonna hold, passe, hold. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Nice. Straight into the fire with that, that core set. Our next move is called a pretzel series. So both legs are at 90 degrees, front leg 90 degrees in front of you, back leg or top leg straight behind you, arms out. Planting this hand firmly for balance. You don't want to collapse into your shoulders in this. We're just gonna lift that knee. Lift, 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 lift. So strong through the core. You should feel work in your obliques as you're lifting that leg. Lift, lift, lift. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two. Point the toe, kick and in. Kick and in, kick. Keeping that knee in the same place, just kicking the leg from the knee, kick and out, kick and in. Four, three, two, one. Last move, flex your foot, push it back. Push that heel back, back. Back, strong through the shoulder, not collapsing. Back, back, back. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Switch to the other side. 90, 90. Strong hand, strong shoulder, hand on hip. Lift, 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 lift. Lifting that leg into the air, feeling the work in the side of your core to lift that leg. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Point the toe, kick, 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 kick. Keeping that knee hovered. We did a lot of work in our glutes today, so this is probably a challenge at this point, but really try to keep that knee hovered. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Flex the foot, last move, kick back, kick. So again, maintaining that 90 degree angle of the knee, just kicking back from the glute, kick, kick. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Side plank series. option knees, option one knee, option feet stacked, option top foot in front. Take whatever works for you. I'm on my elbow. For this, we're gonna do thread the needle, bringing it through, up, dip, up, thread the needle, and dip. Thread the needle, and dip. You are not obligated to stay up on your feet if that's where you started. Feel free to come to your knee if you need. Dip and up, thread the needle and up. Dip and up, thread the needle and up. Two more sets. Dip and up, thread the needle and up. Last set, dip, needle, hold, hold. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, other side. Ooh, I'm trying to get everything in under the wire, you guys. Setting up, thread the needle and dip. Thread the needle and dip. Nice, I am seeing so much hard work out there. This is not an easy sequence, especially after everything we've already done. So keep it up. You're doing awesome. Dip. Thread the needle. Dip. Thread the needle. Dip. Thread the needle. Two more sets. Dip. Thread the needle. Dip. Thread the needle, hold, hold. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release. Okay. I hope we have time for one more core move, but I think we need to move on to our stretch. So let's start with a hip flexor and quad stretch. I'm going to get my towel for this. If you can hold on to both legs with your hands, great. I think I cannot catch them both. So I'm going to use my towel as a strap, I hope, or maybe I'll just alternate. I'll just alternate. So holding on, you can drop your chin to the mat if you'd like. You can keep it up, whatever is comfortable for you. I'm going to switch. So if you're just doing one, switch. Otherwise, if you want more stretch and you're doing both, you can lift those knees up off the mat. Really nice. Good job. And release. Slowly coming to a seated position. We're going to do a seated twist. So one knee bent on the floor, other leg, foot planted on the mat. Hug your legs and then open to the side of the top leg, looking over that back shoulder. Tall spine should give you a nice stretch in your glutes and your hips. Did a lot of work on these little piriformis and the psoas and all these other muscles on the side of our glutes. So let's thank them with a nice stretch. Switch to the other side. Embrace that leg. Plant the hand behind you. Look over the shoulder. Nice. Letting your breathing and your heart rate slow. Wow, that really, this class super flew by, you guys. Slowly unfurl yourself for a last stretch. Let's do a standing triangle. So we'll have our feet wide, one foot to the front of the room, other foot to the side of the room, reaching over to the foot that's touching to the side of the room. Ah. Keeping those shoulders parallel. Say hello to my husband as he goes upstairs. Engaged in the top arm. You can let that bottom hand slide down your leg if you'd like. And now inhale that top arm up. Switch your feet. Other side, over, over, over until you can't go any further, over. And then, and I like my hand on the inside of my leg. Some people prefer on the outside. Some people can bring it down to the mat. Engage top hand, thinking about so much distance right here in that sacroiliac joint. And lift it up. Both feet out into your wide, super widest second position, power second position. Come down here. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Fill your lungs and then blow out all that carbon dioxide that you generated. One last time. Inhale. Exhale to your plie. Ladies, take your curtsy. Gentlemen, take your bow. Thank you very much, you guys. I'll see you next week. I'm just gonna stop the recording. Great.